Hi, I'm Emily from The Blue Mouse, and today I'm going to show you how to work the standard knit bind-off, which will give you a bind-off edge that looks like this. And it is really perfect for beginners because it's very easy to learn. So to begin, you're going to knit the first two stitches. So for beginners, you're going to go into the front loop of that first stitch, and then you're going to wrap the yarn from front to back over your right-hand needle, pull it through, and then slip off. And do the same thing for the second stitch, into the front loop, yarn over front to back, pull through, slip off. And then you'll have two stitches on your right hand needle. And what you're going to do is pass the first stitch over this second one here and off. So we go into the front loop of this first stitch here. And now you might want to hold on to the second stitch with your index finger on your right hand. And you're going to pass this stitch over the other and off. Okay, so you had two and now you only have one, so you have bound off one stitch and it should kind of look like that. So from now on we just need to knit one stitch at a time. So we're going to go ahead and knit one more stitch into the front loop, yarn over front to back, pull through and off. And then we're going to repeat the bind off process. So go into this first stitch here, pass it over the second and off the needle. So go into the first one from left to right, and then you're going to pass it over and off the other. So put your index finger on that second so it doesn't slide off too, and then pass the first over and off. And you're just going to keep doing that. So knit one, then go into the stitch that is furthest from the tip, or what I'm calling the first stitch, pass it over and off. And again, over and off. Now you want to be careful that you don't pull too tight because your bind off will be super tight. So you want to kind of find a middle ground between being too loose and being too tight. So you can see that this is what mine looks like right now, and I'd say that's a pretty good tension. But if you're worried, always err on the side of it being looser rather than tighter. And I like to make sure that my stitch on my right hand needle is not too tight when I go to knit that next stitch. So this isn't too tight on my right hand needle, so I'm ready to knit the next one and bind off. Make sure that it's not too tight and just keep doing that across your work. And when you get down to having only two stitches left, you just knit the final stitch as normal and then work that final bind off. And then you'll have that one stitch left. So just kind of pull up a little bit of a loop, leave yourself a tail to weave in later, and go ahead and cut the yarn. Now you can just take this loop and pull the tail through it. Okay? And your bind off is complete. And it looks super neat and tidy. So there you have it. That is how you work the standard knit bind off.